Sabi ko nga, dyan lang yung statement natin, no? So I cannot tell the details on that, but mataas doon sa sinabi natin before na decision ng House yung last time na recommendation, and it's up for the again for the plenary to take up and consider our recommendation.
Sir, so mas mataas sa suspension?
It could be something may mga suspension or may additional or might be higher to that. No?
Let's just talk about that.
As usual, the Committee on Ethics always doing its committee hearings in executive manner. No? So we hope you would understand because this is always considering the confidentiality of the matter because we talk on the members of the House here. So for your information, the after our meeting, again, would like to announce with you right now that the Committee on Ethics and Privileges unanimously decided to recommend to the plenary the imposition of a stiffer disciplinary action to our colleagues, no? Arnulfo Alni Atives Jr. for violation of the rules of the House of Representatives, particularly Rule 20, Section 142, Subsection A and B of the Code of Conduct, and for disorderly behavior. So, and you might be asking, bakit hindi natin inallow at inopen yung online participation of the respondent here? Again, as always, this is a collegial decision which the chair cannot decide on his own, no? So, kanina, before we proceed and start with our meeting, a decision obtained from this committee that the members unanimously decided again that we are going to sustain our rules not to allow Respondent Arnie Atives sa Zoom. So, because we really require the personal appearance, no, of our respondent, and this is always in pursuant in the inconsistent with the rules of the House of Representatives and the rules of the Committee on Ethics and Privileges. So again, that's the committee decisions for your information, and we conducted the meeting kanina twice yung executive session because we need really to come up with a decision coming from the members, no? And then we exhausted our discussions on this because it is not an easy decision for the committee because we are all members and we need really to ensure appropriate protection, no, of our colleagues also here in the House of Representatives. Okay, so if you have some other follow-up questions, we have our Vice Chair here and then the Sec Gen of the House. Okay? If we can do this by tomorrow, so probably we can submit na, no? It depends how the committee secretariat able to come up, no, and then with my supervision, and it was already approved, no, by the committee to authorizing the secretariat and the chair to present our report in the Committee on Rules. So it's up for the Committee on Rules kung kailan nila i-agenda ang report ng ating committee. But then try to take note na dalawang araw na lang ang natira before the break of the sine day of this House of Representatives.
Hello, sir, good afternoon. Sir, when you say stiffer disciplinary action, ano po yung tinitingnan natin na disciplinary action?
Sabi ko nga, dyan lang yung statement natin, no? So I cannot tell the details on that, but mataas doon sa sinabi natin before na decision ng House yung last time na recommendation, and it's up for the again for the plenary to take up and consider our recommendation.
Sir, so mas mataas sa suspension?
It could be something may mga suspension or may additional or might be higher to that. No?
Let's just talk about the House rules. Ano po ba yung penalty that is stiffer than the suspension based on our House rules?
Chair.
Okay, yes, okay. Vice Chair.
Let me answer that question. Based on the House rules, the stiffer penalty from the suspension is expulsion. And there is another penalty that can be imposed. Any penalty that the committee may determine. So yun na lang po yung mga natitirang options. But I'm not saying that yun po yung decision or recommendation ng committee.
Sorry again.
I'm sorry, but we are not at liberty to divulge because we were not given the consent of the majority of the members of the Committee on Ethics. And that is why maybe we can just wait for another day or 2 days so that for you to know what is the recommendation of the Committee on Ethics and Privileges.
Kung naiparating na po ba kay Congressman Tevez yung unanimous na decision po ng House Ethics Panel?
So far, hindi naman yun agad, no? I mean, binibigay. It depends to we are going to really report to the plenary our recommendations.
Mm-hmm.
So it's up for the plenary to adopt our recommendation or might be pwede rin i-disapprove na plenary.
Pero kung ano po yung naging mabigat na rason para po patawan ng stiffer penalty si Congressman? Kasi before po, di ba, ang pinag-usapan yung pagliban niya sa trabaho without travel authority. Pero ngayon po, meron pa bang ibang, kumbaga, binigyan kayo ng bigat? Kaya ganito po yung naging decision ng committee?
Yeah, na-discuss na rin yun kanina, kaya medyo may binanggit tayo na medyo stiffer na action by the committee.
Sir, ano kaya? Like, yung bang political asylum na kinukuha ni Congressman Tevez before sa Timor-Leste, among others po?
We have discussed that, but then abangan na lang dun sa committee reports namin kasi nasama rin yun.
What was the need for the presence of the COMELEC chairman?
Our resource persons, in-explore natin yung mga informations doon. But then, again, those deliberations and discussed within the committee are all considered as classified. Again, we are not in the liberty again to disclose because even our resource person been instructed na hindi pwede ibanggit all the board kasi whatever documents or informations coming out on the committee hearings considered as classified material. So we're not in liberty to tell you on that.
Sir, comment niyo. Sabi ni Congressman Tevez at Attorney Topacio, nag-commit kayo ng abuse of discretion and abuse of authority. Yung hindi pag-allow sa kanyang mag-sue ng walang basis.
Okay, Vice Chair, we have our... yeah. Now, we sustain our decision to that dahil executive session itong ating committee and we really wanted to ensure na maging consistent din kami sa mga previous decisions, no? At saka ginawa action din ng committee na really the physical appearance of a respondent is really needed and it was adopted by this committee and nandiyan naman yon sa rules o procedure ng committee natin na confidential ito, and then this committee has really the option, no, to really implement the whatever measures in order to protect the proceedings, and how are we going to conduct our hearing. So yun ang na agree ng ating committee. So we're just only executing it, na we're not going to allow the participation via online.
Congressman, for the record, anong mga government agencies yung inimbita kanina sa Ethics Committee hearing?
Are we going to the world? Nandito naman sila kanina.
Oh, yeah. We invited, of course, the chairman of the COMELEC. Secondly, the Bureau of Immigration. Also, the Department of Foreign Affairs, the Civil Service Commission, and the Philippine National Police.